Welcome to the online moral science class. Students, in this video, I'll be taking the chapter The Selfless Love of Mother. Mother is one of the most valuable gift of God. Valuable means so precious that one cannot assign a price. She is the person who does things for you selflessly. Selflessly means caring more for what other people need and what rather than for what you yourself need and want. She will always make you a priority in her life. She never expects any return for what she does. All that she wants is your love and affection. There are few things that you might not know. Your mothers might have fed you with their hands in your infancy, means your early childhood when you were too small. They might have spent many sleepless nights in sitting beside you in your sickness and illnesses. Moreover, they cook yummy food for you. They make you ready for school. They help you in completing your homework. For example, right now when the online classes are going on, your mummy or your daddy as well might be helping you in completing your work. But this chapter is about mothers. All round the clock, they just work and work for your betterment so that you'll be a better person, you will study well. They make every effort to make you become a good human being. When people praise you, they become happy. They find their happiness in your happiness. They sometimes scold or punish you, but that is also for your benefit, so that you will not do something wrong. It is the duty of every child to take care of his or her mother. You should always be loving and affectionate towards your mother. You can show your love and affection and gratitude towards your mother by obeying her, reciprocating her love, and by being respectful towards her. Students, gratitude means being thankful for all the things that your mommy is doing from the morning till the time you go to bed. And reciprocating means to give and take mutually. Like she loves you, so you also love her. Now in this chapter, we are going to read a beautiful story about mother's love. The story's name is The Mother's Last Wish. Once, a boy and a girl were married. They started living happily. Soon, God blessed them with a child. They rejoiced and thanked God. They named the child as Ajay. Time passed and Ajay grew up. Soon he became settled in his life and started earning good amount of money. His parents married him. Soon after his marriage, unfortunately, his father died. After a few months, Ajay took his mother to an old age home. Students, old age home is a place where old people can live together and be cared for when they are too weak or ill to take care of themselves. He used to visit the old age home every Sunday and give some gifts and money to his mother. Days, months, and then years passed. One day, Ajay received a call from the old age home. The manager said, Your mother has become very serious. She won't last long. Won't last long means might die soon. She was not well. She wants to meet you immediately. Ajay rushed to the old age home. At the old age home, he saw his mother lying helplessly on the bed. Seeing her son, she said, "Son, I want something from you. I want you to get a few fans installed in the old age home. Moreover, also get a fridge, as many times the food gets spoiled." Ajay was amazed. He said,
"Mom, you are staying here since a long time. You never asked me about these things. Now, when only a few hours of your life are left, you are asking me for these things. How will these things benefit you?"
At this, his mother replied, "No, my son, I don't need these things for myself. I was somehow able to bear the heat and the hunger pain. But, my child, when one day your child will send you here, you will not be able to bear these things." Saying this, she closed her eyes, which never opened again. Ajay started crying bitterly. He realized his mistakes, but till then, it was too late. Students, we owe a lot to our mothers, not only mothers, to our parents. For all the things that they have done for us, they give us food, clothing, shelter, provide us with education. In the above story, the last wish of the mother showed her extreme love and affection towards her son. Moreover, it also showed how good the mother was, as she happily tolerated the injustice of his son for many years without complaining, although she was living in the old age home with all these problems for many years, but she never complained. She wanted her child to live happily with his family, so she even went to the old age home. Children, you should always be loving and caring towards your parents. Reciprocate their love and always remain indebted to them. If you do not want to cry bitterly like Ajay, never separate your mothers from your lives. Instead, try to love your mothers, or you can say parents, as much as you can. Do all the things which give them happiness. Never be rude or use harsh words. Students, from this chapter you learn that we owe everything to our parents. The way they have cared for us, fulfill each and every needs that we have. So when you grow up, and right now also, you're supposed to love them back, respect them, be obedient and good boys. Because even if they scold you at times, that is for your betterment. So obey your parents, students, listen to them, and when you grow up, take care of them the same manner they are taking care of you right now. I hope you have understood the importance of your parents in your life. Make sure that you read the chapter one more time. I hope you have understood the chapter. Stay safe, listen to your parents, and study. Thank you.